Okay, so welcome back to part two of our discussion of concepts of economics related to engineering content. Okay, so let me share again my screen kasi magsusunod na tayo ng mga problems. Ito tayo natapos from lecture part one. Nakalimutan ko na sabihin class ng assets and liabilities. Debit, ito yung, di ba? Debit card. Tandaan nyo na lang. Debit, bawas. Di ba? Credit card, umuutang ka, nai-increase na net worth. Ganun lang yun. Okay, plus. So, let's now talk about this problem. In engineering economic problem class, number one here is nakaka-intimidate yung haba ng tanong. So, in this case, napakahaba ng tanong pero iilan lang yung questions. Diba? So, the crucial part here is kinakailangan nyo lang basahin ng ito naging practice ko na no, whenever I solve engineering problems. Basahin mo muna yung problema. Basahin mo muna yung problem, internalize mo for the first 10 minutes. Then you follow a methodology of solution. So papakita ko sa inyo how do I approach it later on. Ito na lang, GSA. You write all the given, what is asked, no? And then solution, and then your final answer. Gasa, no? What is asked? Okay, sige, let's start. So in this problem, meron daw new highway, paving a new highway. The contractor has a choice of two sites on which to set asphalt mixing plant equipment. So, asfalto. Kalsada, asfalto. The contractor estimates that it will cost 120 pesos per cubic meter per cubic meter kilometer. The job involves 50,000 cubic meters of asphalt paving materials. It will be estimated that the work will be done from March till the end of June. Dalawa, kanina, di ba sinabi natin na two options. We have site A and site B. Okay? Alternatives. Pag daw si B yung pinili mo, there will be an added 600 pesos per day. Ibig sabihin may additional kang labor. So which of the two is better? For the selected site, how many cubic meters of asphalt does the contractor have to deliver the job site before starting to make a profit if paid at 1,000 pesos per cubic meter? Okay. So, lilista na natin yung mga given. Okay? So, given. Okay. So kung hindi niyo na ano, balikan niyo na lang, no? Balikan natin yung problem, tapos screenshot niyo. Okay? Para isa-isaan maano natin, masundan niyo properly yung solution. Okay, number given. The cost asphalt cost will be 120 pesos per meter cube kilometer. Take note class ha, yung dimensional analysis nyo, baka dyan kayo magkamali. 120 pesos per meter cube, cubic meter kilometer. Okay? Ano pa? The job involves, ano yung volume? Ilang asfalto daw? That will be 50,000. Mali. Sorry. That will be 50,000 cubic meter. Okay? However, kapag si site B daw, for site B, ang pinili, there will be an additional cost for Lagyan natin to ng asphalt. Asphalt. Cost for flag B or flagman B. That will be 600 pesos per day. Okay? And the question is ito pa. Ganun ba katagal yung project? The time period, yung proyekto will run until March till the end of June. March, April, May, June. That will be 4 months equivalent also to sa palagay na nating 30 days, that will be 120 days. Arawan kasi, no? Arawan yung bayaran sa pagpalagay na natin. So ano pa? From our table, meron tayong average hauling distance compared and the monthly rental ng mga site, pati ng mga equipment. So isa-summarize lang natin ang mga to. And syempre, kung ano yung mas mababa, yun yung site na pipiliin natin. Okay? Let's start! Solution. That will be, lista pa lang muna natin. What is ask? Gasa. Kailangan natin ng pipili ka for A or B. And letter B, volume at 1,000 pesos per cubic meter. Question. Okay, so solution. Ito total muna natin lahat ng kay A. So summary ng cost for A. So that will be, ang average hauling distance ni A is 10.5 kilometer. So sa kada kilometro daw, meron tayong cost na 120 pesos. Tama ba? Per meter, kilometer. Okay. Tingnan nyo, class, ha? Cost ang usapan, ibig sabihin pera. Tingnan nyo to. Peso ba to multiplied by kilometer? Meron pa tayong cubic meter. Di ba? Pag-isipan nyo lang, ano ba yung kailangan ko i-multiply dyan para mag-cancel yan? Ito yung volume. Di ba? Per hauling volume, eh. That will be 50,000 cubic meters. Okay? So, dimensional analysis will cancel out the following. Kilometer, kilometer, and you will left with, you are left behind with pesos. So, doing my calculator works a while ago, that will be equivalent to, ay, hindi ko pa pala tinot. I-summarize na natin para mabilis. Plus, that will be monthly rental of the site, 75,000. So that will be 75,000 pesos multiplied by 4 months. Per month, that will be 4 months. Cancel out ulit, and you will left behind with pesos. And then finally, ano pa? Kulang pa ba? That will be 1 million the cost of equipment plus 1.1 million. A total of 64.45 million pesos. Okay? That's for A. Now, ngayon kay B, what will be the cost for B? Total din natin. Ang hauling distance daw kay B is 7.2 kilometers multiplied by 120 pesos per cubic meter per kilometer multiplied by 50,000 cubic meter. Cancel out ulit, di ba? And you will be left with pesos. Adding up, monthly rental, ito medyo malaki-laki. 350,000 yung site nila per month multiplied by 4 months. Cancel out ulit. And then finally, adding up, equipment, mas mahal din. 1.9 million pesos. Totaling everything, that will give us 46 million point 5. Okay? So choosing, anin yung best, much better? So the ideal site is site B. Bakit? Mas mura siya. 46.572 actually million pesos. Ngayon, that's for letter A. We choose site B. Now, the question for B, what is the volume at 1,000 cubic meters? Kung kailan siya magsisimulang mag-profit. So, for the solution for B, simple lang. You will just simply divide the two. That will be 46 profit will be 46.572 million divided by 1,000 pesos. Per cubic meter. So that answer will be ano yung magka-cancel? Yung pesos. Diba? Magka-cancel si pesos. That will give us 10^6 yan. So that will be 46.572 cubic meters. So that's the answer for that one. Ibig sabihin, at 46.573, kita na siya. Diba? Kumita na siya ng 1,000 dun sa first cubic meter. So pag dalawang cubic meter na, kita ulit siya ng 2,000 in increment. Okay? Napakadali lang. We choose site B, at the same time, we choose, maghihintay lang tayo ng makabenta tayo ng 46,573 cubic meters of soil for profit. Alright, you may screenshot this para ma-review. And let's proceed number 2. Medyo mas mahabang problema at mas maraming computation to. A company produces daw an electronic, naalala ko tuloy ang aking thesis, no? On meron kaming project sa electrical engineering, kumuha kami ng solar-powered battery charger. Eh kasi 'di ba during my time kasi yung battery noon, kailangan mo pang tanggalin yung battery sa cellphone mo kasi sasaksak mo doon. Tapos yung charger, meron kaming kung nakakonect ang solar panel. Napakagandang proyekto. Anyways, so, electronic timing switch that is used in consumer products may be made by several manufacturing firms. We have a fixed cost of 1.45 million and a variable cost of 1,500 per unit. Dito class, medyo critical to. Ah. Baka marito kayo dito. I-explain ko mamaya. The selling price, meron tayong demand function of per unit of 3,600 minus 0.4D. So for this situation, we need to find the optimal volume and then find the volume of the demand at which the break-even occurs. Meaning, walang profit. Okay. What are the given? What are the given? Number 2. Parang mas gusto kong lakihan yung ano. Lalakihan ko lang class yung ano. Yung white background. Maliit kasi. Alam mas malaki yung mag-sulat. Tingnan mo na sa. Oh, yan. Example number two, given. The following cost, fixed cost of 1.45 million. Variable cost with the demand function of 1,500. Ito na kasi mag-iiba to. Per unit D. Diba? Kasi at dalawa yung mabentang switch, 1,500 times 2 yun. So take note lang, yung D will be in units. Okay, the selling price, we have the demand function of P is equal to 3,600 pesos minus 0.4 multiplied by the number. Okay, what is asked for us? That will give us the optimal volume. And then volume where the break even is. B, sabi ng the script. Okay? So solution. Dito class na meron tayong kakaibang approach na gagawin. Okay, meron tayong kakaibang approach na gano'n. Tuwing kailan mag-i-equal ang break-even? Tuwing kailan ba nangyayari ang break-even? Break-even occurs when the profit is equal to zero. Tama ba? When the profit is equal to zero. So, ibig sabihin, wala ka rin cost. Now, the break-even is equivalent to the total revenue is equivalent to the cost. Okay? The total revenue is equivalent to the total cost. Okay? So, pwede na natin to mag-create tayo dito ng equation. Tama ba? Is equal to or the profit is equal to zero. Okay. So that will give us TR minus TC, the total cost, is equivalent to the profit function. Okay. So that will give us, ano yung formula for the total revenue? Our equation 1, kung naalala nyo. That will be price multiplied by the demand. That will be price multiplied by the demand. Okay. Minus. The total cost of 1.45 million. Lagyan ko ng bracket ha. 1.45 million, the total cost. Plus, ano pa? Yung per unit. Diba? Yung per unit. Cost per unit. That will be 1,500 per unit. Tama ba yun? Tama. 1,500 per unit. Is equal to 0. However, the price function is this. Tama ba? Tulayan natin. Ako malita. May nothing blue. The price function is ito. So that will give us 3,600 minus 0.4D multiplied by the demand minus 1.45 million minus 1,500. Okay. Page 2. A column 2. So solving, we will have the following. Negative 0.4 d squared. I-simplify ko na class, ha? Plus plus 3,600 d minus 1.45 million minus 1,500. Ganito yung pesos yun. Pesos yun. Less, smeg, sa minsan yan. Putik yan. So, dito, ayoko lang, i-simplify nyo lang yung common terms na meron tayong dito class. Meron kang d doon. Meron kang d doon. And meron kang d squared. So, you have a quadratic function of this term. That will be 0.4 d squared minus 2,100 q d pala, sorry, plus 1.45. So, this will be your star equation. Eto na. Turuan ko kayo, class, kung paano mag-solve ng quadratic equation using your scientific calculator. So for everyone using Casio, i-press nyo lang si mode, then makikita nyo si equation at 5. So press mode, then press 5, then choose number 3 as your quadratic function. And then i-insert nyo lang yung mga coefficients. So that will be 0.4 for A, negative 2,100 for B, and constant is 1.45 exponent to the 6. Then press equal. So we will have D equivalent to 4,432, tama ba? And then 817, tama. 4,432, and then 817. So, ibig sabihin, this will be our range. No? This is your answer. Ito yung optimal volume range. So, pwede natin itong baksan. Optimal range. Ibig sabihin, at those range, meron kang profit. Okay? Meron kang profit. Now, question for letter B. What is asked for letter B? Volume where the break-even occurs. Volume where the break-even occurs. Now, ngayon, tandaan nyo, class. Dalawa kasi, marami kasing tanong dito. Maraming tanong dito. Sa letter B is, kailan nag-break-even? E di kailangan mo lang, ito, isolve yung function na to. Diba yung itong function na to, yung star na to. So, solving that, equivalent to z. No. Bali pala. Dito class, no, sa break even of course at this points, tama ba? Pag in-equate natin to dito, try natin na 817 squared times 0.4 minus 2,100 times 817. Yun, no? Tama, oh. Plus 1.45 XP to the 6. Yun. Minus 2,100. Tama. All 1.45 XP to the 6. That will be 0. Di ba? At this level, at this range, at the range of for yung todo na, todo na. But so this limits 817 and 4432. Those are break even points. Meaning profit is equivalent to zero. Ngayon, question. Yun yung sagot sa break even, di ba? Yun yung limits. Ngayon, pag yung pasok na range within those para magkaroon tayo ng profit. Question. Paano naman if tinanong tayo na gusto natin malaman yung max profit? Kailan mo makukuha yun? At what level? Interesting, di ba? Interesting things. Ganito lang kasi yung approach. Di ba sa in your elementary analysis, in your integral, differential calculus, kailan mo makukuha yung maximum point in a quadratic function? Di ba? Quadratic to eh. Di ba? Negative 0.4 yan. So, ibig sabihin, facing downward, meron kang maximum point. Yung tok-tok. Di ba? I think that is what we call the vertex. So, paano mo siya makukuha? Ibig sabihin, you need to take the tangential line by taking the first derivative. Tapos, yun yung value. Yung value ng point na yun, yun yung maximum profit. So, taking the second, not the second, and the first derivative. The first derivative. So, taking the first derivative, that will be 0.8D minus 2,100 or equals to 2,100. D is equivalent to 2,625. Ibig sabihin, pag nakabenta tayo ng ganyang karaming switches na units, yun yung maximum profit. Okay, and for you to confirm that this is a maximum profit, just take the second derivative. Diba? 0.4 to eh. So, taking the second derivative, that will be negative 0. Ilan yun? Negative 0.4. Diba? Negative 0 point. No. Second derivative of this function. That will be negative 0.8. So, from this negative alone, alam mo na na facing down. Kaya, makoconfirm mo na tama na. Diba? Na-validate mo that this will give you the maximum profit. Okay? So, yun lang. And, pwede nyo ulit screenshot ito. And, sit work. Yan. So, paki-screenshot na lang din. So, for your practice problem. Ngayon, class, mayroon kayong mga tanong. You can email me personally, send me a message in my social media accounts, or comment down in this video if you will have any questions. So, that will be it for our part 1 of concepts in economics. See you in lecture 2. Bye-bye.